thing. String theory. And then a couple other things as well. The horse. Trojan horse, as in Hercules, but Trojan horse specifically. For the winning of the season, the winnings of the season, pretty much. The being that is coming, coming back. I remember the mic is not played, the phone is played through here. The Trojan horse, string theory, black mass, played. I'm sure many people have heard of this.
don't like or trying to come against would make more sense to me on the topic, you know. Rather, you know, if you're on a good side, bad side, or whatever your beliefs are within your own belief system, pretty much. And that's probably my best way, because even though reading through the articles and everything, the best way I can describe it is, and I even heard someone talking about, yeah, that the churches have their own revival, so does the Satanic Church, and some of these operations, they just call it, it's the Satanic Black Masses. So yes, that's pretty much all it is. It's a revival for the Satanic Temple Church, whatever, and all its people. So, and some of the articles were talking about over 14,000, 20,000 witches will meet, and they will pray. They'll even form pentagrams or whatever else, light fires, I guess. So, yeah. Other things going into string theory, and you can fall back and I can go back to the graphene of what I was talking about. That even with the graphene, the string theory promotes a message that it's connected with the dark matter, and the dark matter, I would say, goes into the string theory, because once Einstein's theory was, I brought it up before, it's talking about taking the universe and you fold the universe in half, fold it in half. And we'll go through it. Apparently, yes, we have different dimensions, so once you poke a hole, you'll go to the form of a wormhole to get to other dimensions, other size, and so he claimed. And that one has to realize, like, where does the whole thing about dark matter would come from? And going into graphing, because they all connect, that the universe is from this physical realm, we're into the spiritual realm, connect, but you can see it brought into our realities by string theory. You could use that as an example from string theory that you would put together, and it all makes sense once you're going from this world to other universes and dimensions and parallel universes, or whatever you want to call it. So you you would definitely be able to can see something like that happening. So in my take on it, as far as like wormholes and parallel universes and dimensions, I do believe we have different dimensions. We probably have about 9 to 12. Things of how they view it. So once extra-dimensional, which they've already kind of done already. Some of the China buildings and overseas and places like China and Thailand, everything have the printing, 3D, 5D buildings and stuff, buildings that are able to flux in different ways. It's all possible with graphene too, so. And also, that's it's like a warrior spirit, basically. And it shows us something. It shows us that, to my belief, that no matter where you would come from, no matter who you are in life, you're capable. And like I said, this is just my belief on this. Nothing, no historical facts or anything. I've researched it, right? Like, that was just my own belief, that the Trojan horse symbology is really just more about no matter who you are, no matter where you come from, no matter your background, age, ethnicity, age, whatever, that people are capable of great things, doing great things, but yes, we're also capable of doing bad things as well due to our free will. Yeah, I think you're actually right about going back to the topic. Yeah, definitely. I do believe that. Because, like, what you're saying, it traces back and everything. But, I do believe that. But, yeah, I totally, I can see that. But, Trojan horse, okay. Not to be funny, but, like, to me, it's symbolic for a warrior spirit. And it's just really a representation of the conqueror, of a person conquering a situation, or maybe conquering things in their life. It could be addiction, something traumatic happened during your life, and you're just trying to get through it, conquer it, and it's just about overcoming that situation. And you have a warrior spirit of kingship. You have a warrior spirit of conquering. You're a conqueror, basically, in your life, and it doesn't matter who you are. And so, I mean, just that alone should give a person, you know, faith, hope, that they can do different things. We're capable, all human beings are capable of doing great and spontaneous things about life, in our lives, basically. And we, you know, we have to grow to glow, glow to grow, as I always like to say. And, mistakes in order to learn. But one thing I can say is don't run off of everyone else's narratives, even if it's your school teacher, your boss, everyone else. Don't run off of other people's narratives. Form your own thoughts, form your own ideas in life, because we need, this world is really not full of free thinkers. If you want to know the truth about it, to me, it's not full of free thinkers, like, because it seems to me in society, if you can step out of the realms of this world, that, you know, you get pushed aside, you're not, you know, it's just like maybe programming, you know, like, I believe in a lot of ways, yes, we are all programming, you know, we're all being programmed, we're all programmed. It makes me think of AI too and everything else, you know. And so you could see, going back to the Trojan horse symbology, that deprogramming what you think, to relearn about your own beliefs, what, asking yourself, well, what are my own beliefs, what do I believe in, what are my own opinions, what are my own thoughts about thing, being a free thinker is what it's really about, and see the Trojan horse's symbology of being a free thinker, a conqueror, a warrior, an overcomer, and of who you really are, and you think for yourself, because once you start thinking for yourself, that's when they're going to say you're stepping out of line, you need to get back in the line, you're radical, you're this, you're that, and in many cases, yes, a lot of people are like that now, because it really is due to the programming that we as people have been put under, and if we can actually just start to form our own thoughts, our own, opinions, our own beliefs, I think also with that being said, we feel and can be more free in destined to go down is the path I would say you need to take. No matter people's opinions, beliefs, or whatever, do the path, take a narrow path that would be what divides you the most. For sure. Outside of the realm of how others feel or think or believe what you should do. You're going to get opinions left and right. You need to do this. You need to do this. This is not like an idea. You need to do this. Yeah, some way it's beneficial, but at the same time, we as human beings need to be free thinkers. And if you feel like you need to have, we need to, in some way, do need to be rewired in a lot of ways, but we need to have our own beliefs. That we have always dreamed of and desired and wanted all along. We just have to go and sometimes take risks and